Plain Pat, what up? Always felt like we should get paid. Be on magazines, but we get played. Why did he say it? I don't know. Ask gay. Now I'm on the magazines where the roses are. Popping champagne and that rose dime. Won a few awards, then we went on tour. And yep, in my bag, a whole bag of porn. The scenes hate them, then they love them, then they hate them. Fuck it, what to say to you? Cover of the fader. Yeah. Now I'm on my way up. Now you remember want that? Me say what? Huh? You want me say what? Man. I be talking my shit, so I guess I'm an asshole. They be kicking, pushing like Luffy Asco. I guess every time I'm just gonna get in that mode. Suck up to the press, I guess I missed that boat. I did an interview with the Rolling Stones. Read the interview, man, the whole shit wrong. Far as the shit go, you know the way I wanna go. I need, I go to recount that vote. You know, think that you know, but you have no idea. Think you really know, but you have no idea. You think you really know, but I'm right here. You think you really know, but you have no idea. And I'm gonna be the same my whole career. I'm gonna be the same my whole career. You know, this is my problem with interviews, you know. What if you did music and someone else could come in and change your words around and then release it to the radio, and you didn't even get a chance to listen to it before they dropped it to radio? That's how interviews are. You say what you say, and then you'll get paraphrased, and then they'll do shit like, if you say a joke, most jokes are inappropriate. They're like fucked up things that you say, but it's kind of funny the way you word them. And if you take away, you know, the setup or the punchline, you just sound absolutely crazy, which is, they love to do that because I love the joke and I give them too much, and then my shit don't be all like dry ass interviews and stuff. Like, I don't have media training or whatever. And then so they take that, and I told Gabe, I said, look, well, I want to get approval over the shit, just because I want it to be as entertaining as possible. I want people to have the information. And you know, like a lot of magazines, they got real uptight. They're like, no, you won't get approval, you won't get approval, you won't get approval. So, you know, when I say the line about the Rolling Stones, I don't have a problem with Rolling Stones. I really appreciate the fact that they did put me on a magazine. And I realized that, you know, I was halfway out of my mind for the past 2 years and shit. I was, you know, off that drug called fame and shit like that. I was like a little crazy, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've calmed down and shit and like come back down to earth. So, you know, for the editor, Rolling Stone, all that, I wanted to say that. But I do want to say that it was pieces of the article, there was information in the article that was incorrect. And, you know, if you allow me to proofread it, the people could have had the proper information. And just to speak to, you know, the De La Chapelle, because De La Chapelle is one of my favorite photographers, modern day Warhol. I want to speak to the cover. You know, people say, okay, well, he has a guy complex. Fam, if someone's in college and they do, like, a play where they, you know, emulate Christ, do they have a God complex? Are they allowed to do that? You know, it's because of my position. It's like I'm not allowed to be creative. So every cover I take has to just be a picture of my face and shit. Just, look, it's my face. It's me. And sometimes it's like after I see me so much, I get tired of me and shit. I gotta look at me every day. I wanna do shit that's exciting to me. So the Rolling Stones cover was exciting to me. That shit went down in history. I did it purely for creative reasons. It wasn't speaking upon, you know, anything disrespectful to Christianity, to anything like that. It was something I did purely creative. A lot of times I do shit and people take more out of it. You know, like I said, you know, Bush doesn't care about black people. And then people took it and said, well, you said Bush hates black people, or Bush said fuck black people. You know, everybody takes it apart and makes it what they want it to be. When, you know, I just say I express something. You know, the other day somebody came to me like, okay, well, who you voting on, Barack or Hillary? And I'm like, I'm not really political, though. I'm not getting into, like, you know, I'm taking sides and this type of stuff. He's like, what do you mean you're not political? You're not. I'm like, fam, I'm emotional. I'm social. I'm like, I'm an artist. Like, if you give me the opportunity.